One of the most anxious parts of the college process is awaiting your decision. Months have passed since you've initially applied and you're just waiting on that one letter deciding if it's a yes or if it's a no. There's so much you've done in high school and everything is just leading up to this one moment determining if you're going to be spending the next 4 to 5 years of your life at this school. So will I get into RIT? I mean, there's a lot that goes into that. How are your grades? Are you involved? What are your test scores like? If you're watching this, you're probably a really talented, smart, charming individual just like me. Recently, I got to sit with the Dean of Admissions and ask her a couple questions pertaining to the application process and the admittance of students in general.
So just a couple of things, a little background. We used to require tests, SAT or ACT. We've now gone SAT or ACT optional. And this was the first year that we did that for all programs. We look at, most importantly, the most amount of weight of the admissions decision is made on the student's grades. On the spectrum of all the things that we look at, we look at grade point average, we look at the individual classes and how they've done. So for example, if you're a student coming into an engineering program, we have prerequisites. We would not only look at your overall grade point average, but we would look at how you've performed in those individual classes, how you've done at rank, and then we also will get letters of recommendation, we look at your extracurricular activities. Those are the big things we look at, but extracurriculars are looked at even more so for a student who doesn't submit a test.
One thing I really do love about how RIT does it is it's not like an automated thing where they put your test scores in, your GPA, your class rank, and a computer decides if it's a yes or no. They holistically decide based off a lot of factors to see if you're gonna be a great fit at this school. There's a person reading your essay. There's a person looking at your scores, looking at every single class you've taken to determine if you're gonna get in.
We give extra consideration for students who really have taken a more challenging role. So they've taken APs, they've really tried to challenge themselves, they're in a curriculum that most resembles what they would be doing in college.
Now, I didn't forget about the international students either, so I got y'all.
We have many international students who are here studying in the U.S. We're looked at so two different ways. So one is if they're on the U.S. scale, of course, we'd look at them just like a domestic student. If they're a student that is coming in from a school abroad, we of course would look at their grading scales. If you're going to a country where English is not the main language, they do have to provide us with an additional test to prove that they are sufficient in English.
Now, in the event that a student does get waitlisted, there are a couple things that the student can do to try and improve their chances of getting in.
When they apply for admission, there's a question right on the application saying, are you interested in being reviewed under our test optional policy? There is a chance that a student could call us and say, you know, I didn't think I wanted to submit my test scores, but I took the test and I did really well. Can I submit them now? And as long as their admissions decision has not been made yet, we will honor that student.
Now, what about the college essay?
One of the things that I would say is it's got to be genuine. This is the one thing that adds that third dimension that we talk about when we train people in admissions. We are able to hear the voice of the student through the essay, and we do what's called the holistic review. We look at everything and make a decision ultimately about fit and the student's ability to be successful here at RIT.
And one big thing you have to remember is RIT is an institute. So although the acceptance rate may be locked at around 70%, there's a culmination of colleges on campus which do sometimes have a bit lower acceptance rates. When I found this out, I was like, how did I get in? But then I was like, ooh, I'm kind of smart.
And we also practice differential admissions. So differential admissions basically says we're going to look at the business students differently than the engineering students, different than art and design, so on and so forth, because they do have different prerequisites. We will also ask students for a second and third choice. So many institutions would say, well, if you're not admitted to your first choice, then that counts as a deny. We at RIT, if they're admitted for their second choice or their third choice, still count that as an acceptance.
One common misconception that students have is that the school's acceptance rate is directly correlated with how rigorous it is, and that is not true.
That's exactly right. And a lot of people say that. A lot of people say, it's a lot easier to get into RIT than it is to stay into RIT. And it really does depend on the student. But the workload is rigorous at RIT. Yeah. I mean, you know, we really look for reasons to admit. We really look for the students' ability to be successful here. And then many students, and these are the best stories, we take a chance on. And ultimately, in those cases, if we decide to admit, we really see a lot of students who just get here, really press the restart button, and just do unbelievably well.
So most people don't do this, but I'm actually going to give the breakdown of my like transcripts and grades. I was very, very, very involved in high school, active in my community. I did a lot at school. I was the captain of my track team for 2 years. I did theater. I was involved with other sports as well too, on the production side of things. So I did a lot. I believe around my junior year, I had 500 hours clocked in, but my unweighted GPA was around a 3.8. Did take a lot of AP classes as well too, but I was also part of NHS and we did do a lot of community service activities as well. But here's one big thing, all that is cool.
I bombed my SAT.
Like, yo, I did so bad on that. Well, it wasn't terrible, but it wasn't as high as I'd prefer it to be. So I'm not gonna tell you. But in all honesty, you're a great student. You taking the initiative to even watch this video speaks more about you than you even know. And I can assure you, if you just get involved, work on your grades, get in leadership, you'll more than likely get into RIT. It's a great school and we'll be happy to have you here. So yeah.